Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know for this Thursday, July 22nd. Hospitalizations and the rate of transmission continue to rise in New Jersey as the spread of the Delta COVID variant continues. Hospitalizations are nearing 400, still way off pandemic highs, but the rate of transmission has now increased to 1.40. It is now among the highest in the nation. Governor Murphy is still rejecting the idea of a statewide mask mandate when our kids return to school full-time in the fall. However, speaking at a town hall in Cincinnati last night, President Biden says he expects that all kids will be masked up when they go back to school unless a vaccine is approved for younger ages, which he says is probably coming. As for what is next in New Jersey, many of you still ask us daily, are there more restrictions coming? And the answer to that question is, we don't know. However, it does appear something is likely to happen. Dr. Marty Blaser at Rutgers says the variants continue to pop up and the COVID virus itself continues to surprise. And we really have no way of predicting what the next mutation may be. As for New Jersey's economy, Rutgers economist Jim Hughes says the state is seeing a little bit of a slowdown, but still a very strong recovery after most pandemic restrictions were lifted earlier this year. A South River woman is facing bias intimidation charges for another racist rant caught on video. This was in Mount Laurel. 46-year-old Elizabeth Treziak wasn't even staying at the Super 8 motel. She was staying next door, but police say she showed up in the lobby of that hotel and started cursing out the clerk behind the desk. A family member took her away, but then video that was posted to Reddit shows that she returned and went on a tirade, repeatedly using the N-word. She, again, has been arrested and is facing bias intimidation charges. The DEP has closed another Jersey beach. This is the Bayside Beach in Barnegat Light at 25th Street. High fecal bacteria levels have been detected. Have you been squashing those little red and black bugs anytime you see them? That's good. Keep it up. But now the spotted lanternfly is maturing, growing wings, and is taking flight. The species that is native to East Asia first started showing up in New Jersey in 2019. Highly invasive, can destroy trees and crops. We will not have a bear hunt in New Jersey this year. That was one of Governor Murphy's campaign promises when he ran for governor, was eliminating the bear hunt. But the DEP is announcing this year there will not be one. The last one was held the previous December. If you bought a muffin from 7-Eleven or Stop and Shop or Walmart, don't eat it until you check the recall notice, a massive recall announced by the FDA for listeria concerns. If you've already eaten the muffin, well, watch out for symptoms, which can include fever and diarrhea. We have all of the recall details at NJ1015.com this morning. State police have released the sketch of a suspect wanted in a road rage shooting in Bedminster. A driver says the man fired at her car on Route 78 from inside a black SUV. Investigators are also looking for witnesses or dash cam footage from anyone who may have seen the shooting. This happened around 8:30 on July 7th. A porch pirate has been caught after video was posted on social media from the home's Ring camera. Somebody stole several Amazon packages from the front porch of the home in Manchester. The house's Ring doorbell caught the whole thing on video. A number of people in town recognized 18-year-old Asim Hines and called police. He is now charged with theft and keying a car that was in the driveway. We now know it was a mechanical issue that caused this boat to run aground in North Wildwood on Tuesday. The beach was packed. The boat came in at a high rate of speed, taking out some beach chairs, but nobody was hurt. A couple of people and a dog were on the boat. They are also okay. That boat has now been removed. 13-year-old Kylie Holman was at Maury's Pier in Wildwood celebrating a birthday when the two got on the Springshot ride, which launches you into the air at 75 miles an hour. As if that wasn't enough of a thrill, as the ride began, Kylie got hit in the face by a seagull. Video shows Kylie's shock as the bird hits her, sticks to her neck and shoulder. She grabs the seagull, flips it off. She wasn't hurt, and apparently neither was the bird, which just flew away. have something to say about our top stories, leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always talking Jersey, taking your calls on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know for this Thursday, July 22nd. Have a great day.